Hey guys, I am back making new videos and hope you can hear me better now. I got a new phone for myself. Last phone I brought, I thought it was good, but it turns out it's only for video gaming, etc. It's not really for making YouTube videos or Skyping. So I hope that you can hear me now clearer and much better. If not, please let me know. So that I will buy another one because I need to make sure that you get the point across more than anything. So, yeah, guys, before talking about the main points, I wanted to really stress on this the real difference between God and Satan. No matter which God you believe in or not believe in or have seen or not seen, but what is the actual real difference between God and Satan? This is very, very important in the context of things that I'm going to discuss today. So many people, we know God is good and Satan is evil, but the real difference on a higher level, we need to know. It's very, very important. So that I feel, and with my personal experience, the real difference between God and Satan is nothing but God gives you everything when you meet him, guys. I feel this is the most important difference between God and Satan. He doesn't hold back on anything. If you ever come across God, in India there is a saying, जब भगवान देता है तो छप्पड़ फाड़ के देता है, मीनिंग व्हेन गॉड गिव्स ही ब्रेक्स योर रूफ एंड गिव्स एवरीथिंग. सो ही डजन स्टॉप, ही व्हाट एवर ही हैज ही गिव्स यू. सो दैट इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू राइट नाउ इन दिस वर्ल्ड. एंड वी नो दिस वर्ल्ड इज कंप्लीटली कंट्रोल्ड बाय सेटानिक फोर्सेस. एंड अनलेस गॉड, विच गिव्स यू एवरीथिंग, वी नो दिस गाय gives you electricity and petroleum, the two most important things that is controlling the world right now in drips, guys, and nothing but drips and stinginess and in ration, and you have to pay and go back to him again and again and again. So it doesn't stop coming your bills every month when you are under the influence of this guy, and it reinforces tax and debt and makes you a slave because he had made sure if anything that you use, electricity and petrol, the two most important thing on planet Earth, you have to go back again and again. You have to refill your tank. You have to go and pay your bills to get electricity. Nothing is free. We know we have free technology, but we also know that Satan rules this world. He will never give you everything, is my point. You have to go back to him again and again and again. That is the real difference I feel between God and satanic forces on planet Earth. Then I feel this is also the reason they are incredibly smart. The reason we have secret societies, the word itself has this meaning. What I am to say, they hold back on things, guys. Secret society means they don't give you everything. God doesn't hold back on anything, guys. That is my point. This is the reason they have thousands of secret societies spread across all over the world to control human race. All these Freemasons have lots of secrets because they are directly answering to this guy. So if you are working for this guy, even this guy has all the power in this world, but he won't give you everything. He will hold back on things so that you can go back to him again and again and again. And I feel this is also the reason these guys made God cringy and boring and ritualistic. I don't think if you meet a real God, you have to go back to him again and again and create temples around him. I think this is also like satanic. All this in India and mostly all the churches, we know it's controlled by the big governments and all the money. It has become like a money making machine to suck all your energy as well as hard income, and this goes to no one but the elite rulers of this planet Earth. These guys, and these guys made sure that God becomes boring and cringy, so that you, the guys who are good, the guys mostly who are looking for truth and are into conspiracy, get repulsed by the thought of God ever coming and helping you out. Because this is, I feel, is by a deliberate design to make God the most boring and cringy person you will come across, simply because every Sunday, every day, you have to go back to him again and again and again. That is not the case, guys. That is with Satan. You have to go back to him again and again for your problems. But if you ever meet God, you don't have to meet him again. He will give you everything he has, so that you will have enough to create a new universe, new galaxies, etc., etc. So this is very important point, guys. And God, I feel, for personally, this whole big thing is a deliberate act, so that you never understand what really God is and move forward in life. For me, I think God is the best friend you will ever come across, guys. God is the best friend ever, and he is the coolest friend. He is the friend you can always go back with problems, and he will always have a solution in hand, and he will give a best friend. And difference between friend and best friend is, we know that best friend, whatever best friend things are, it's yours, and he doesn't hold back on things. Otherwise he will be just your ordinary friend. You don't go back to ordinary friend for all your problems. It's actually now in this world very difficult to find a best friend, because just like God, it's very difficult to find God. It is actually very difficult to get a best friend in life, because it is how Satan has designed this world, so that you never come across a best friend. And he is also, God is, I feel, is also the coolest person you will ever meet. And we have an example for it, guys. The one thing the Western world, mostly who are into, you know, hippies or truth movement, they are obsessed with is ganja, you know, weed. And we know who invented ganja. What would you think if you know that your best friend is the guy who invented marijuana? Can you imagine that? That is how cool the gods are. They, in India, when the British came, they have completely destroyed the essence and image and what actually the godheads were. They have completely changed the, you know, symbolism of gods. They are actually your best friend and nothing else, is what I feel. You can go back to God with all your problems and say, he will save the day for you. And this sounds like a new age thing, but I just got this image in Google and just wanted to, you know, put it here. So this is not a new age thing, but just to, like, you know, God is your best friend. Whenever you have any issues, you can go back to your best friend and he will give you everything he has. So this is what, keep this in mind, guys, before I come to the main point. And this is, the main point is nothing but this number 7, and this is coming to me like crazy now. And we have discussed this many times, I have made many videos in it, but the intensity of number 7 is off the charts, guys. I will give you an example. I was watching this Anthony Smith, is an American working in the Philippines, and he was making a video of things that are cheaper in Philippines compared to America. And what do you know, that he got the table number 7, and he had subscriber total 7.7 and 736 views. But yesterday, even more crazy thing happened. The thing that this is doing is unbelievable. That is impossible. And what happened was, I was opening a new email account. The Google captcha came. I was so shocked I couldn't save it. But 77XB7, it came something like that. Even in captcha, that is impossible. And yesterday, I was downloading a messenger app, Viber. And I was like, they wanted to authenticate my phone number, PIN number. And this came pin number even came 7707. It was crazy, unbelievable, guys. I don't know that power. We already discussed that power is nothing but Sudarshan Chakra. The entire game of East revolves around number 7, guys. I am now very, very, very confident about it. This is all it is, number 7. That is why it is the most used number in Bible, over 700 times and over 50 times in Book of Revelation. This just one symbol is where the entire world revolves. Our pH, neutral pH is 7. 7 rainbow colors, etc., etc. But we know what 7 is, but now I am seeing its incredible power. It's unbelievable. That is exactly what these people did. Nazis, they are totally against the flow of universe, flow of creation. They have twisted this swastika, guys. You know this is swastika, but this is not the real swastika. They have inverted it. Most of you already know the entire game of this world revolves around this. This is the most powerful symbol ever created on planet Earth. And this is what they did. Involution, if you go to ancient Vedic text, etc., this is what Nazi symbolism is. Involution, destruction, nivriti, evolution, pravarti, 7. They created a swastika which is exact opposite to what creation and nature is, guys. This is what they did to original swastika, or reversing it and giving it a twist. That is why it has become the most evil symbol, but it is the most sacred symbol. If you go to ancient symbols of swastika, they are like Bronze Age. They are all anti-clockwise, but Nazi swastika is clockwise. And many ancient cultures had this swastika, Agni, Vedic god, sacred fire, source of new, fire of soul. You can see amulet of gathered, but many people used it for and against creation. So this is very, very powerful, but wait till you come to who. Even in Hinduism, when the British people came, they twisted it. Actually, most people in India is making a mistake. They are creating an inverted swastika. This is not the right swastika, inverted 7. This is actually very dangerous. So people do not know what the real shape is. Just it's all inverse, wrongly defined. Nazi Haken cross and Buddhist swastika. Buddhist swastika is actually the good one. Distroverse, clockwise, distortion, distorge. Diesel, sunwise, towards God, lucky, good, right hand. So you see 7. This is the right one. And Sinistroverse, anti-sunwise, away from God, unlucky, evil, left-hand path. So this is what the Nazis used, and this is the one that we want, anti-clockwise one. And even cross came from this Nazi symbolism. But this many people may not know, but this is actually this, guys. Swastika is actually Sudarshan Chakra of Lord Vishnu. I would really request you to keep an open mind and get rid of all this religion. And I am very sure that Vishnu and they don't look like that, but this is maybe infiltrated, created by the British when they came. We had lot of images like this, but you can keep that aside. But there is a power in this universe who has this Sudarshan Chakra. It is represented by Swastika actually. So Swastika actually represents the Sudarshan Chakra of Lord Vishnu. This is incredibly powerful. I am researching it since 1 or 2 months, and everything, all our life come down to this, guys. I cannot stress this enough. Just let me prove you. Give me few more minutes. This is the Bronze Age statue. All ancient world had this, the right size swastika. Remember this, guys. This is all there is to this entire universe, entire world. Nothing comes forward and behind this. This is it. Swastika is actually a very auspicious sign, the number one symbolism of this universe itself. And I will just go through Sudarshan Chakra. Sudarshan Chakra is a spinning disc like weapon, literally meaning vision of, which is auspicious. Actually, it's a good thing. But they have twisted it. But this is very, very incredibly powerful weapon in the hands of the creator. but you should know its history. Actually, it was given by Lord Shiva to Lord Vishnu. Please keep an open mind. You don't have to, you know, be a Hindu or a Christian. Just I am myself a Roman Catholic, just for the record. But I go where the knowledge takes me, you know. So I don't care if I can find the right information in Islam or Buddhism or even in Chinese medicine, etc. So I go everywhere. So this is very, very important to understand. Remember, Lord Shiva gave Swastika or Sudarshan Chakra to Lord Vishnu. And we know that Sudarshan Chakra is a weapon to destroy things. This is very, very important, guys, to understand. And what does Lord Shiva do when he starts to destroy this universe, this world? He starts dancing, guys. It's called Tandav. And where do you find this dancing image of Shiva, aka of destruction? When Lord wants to destroy the world, he starts dancing. So this is the most destructive form of Lord Shiva. And this is completely, totally infused in this. As I told it earlier, when God gives, he doesn't hold back. So whatever God Shiva has in this essence, he has given it to the Sudarshan Chakra. And where do you find this form, symbolism? Here, guys. This Nataraj. You find this destructive form of Lord Shiva, the destruction, in nowhere else than CERN, the biggest, one of the biggest conspiracies we know. And what these people are trying is exactly, they are trying to do what Lord Shiva gained, Lord Vishnu gained from Lord Shiva, is God particle, aka they are trying their best to harness this Sudarshan Chakra energy, guys. This is, if you go to physics, chemistry, not so CERN, I believe, is like subatomic particle, Large Hadron Collider. Their God particle BS is nothing but to get hold of this incredible power that is withheld in the Sudarshan Chakra, is what I feel. The reason also they put this, many people, you know, they started, why the hell they have put Nataraj statue, the Shiva destructive symbolism in CERN, because they are searching for this Sudarshan Chakra, Swastika. They are after this power, guys. That is what the Nazis were after too. Everyone is after this Nazi symbolism, aka the good Swastika power. Nazis just using that power for their own advantage, twisting the good power of Sudarshan Chakra for their own advantage. This is what I feel. There is no doubt in my mind, having seen the power of Swastika, that we are in it for the biggest time, the biggest miracle, magic of our entire life, guys. This is going to be incredible journey for all of us. And even when, if you look in this 7, it is the most used number in, even in Bible, if you are like into Christian, significance of number 7, used in Bible more than 700 times, used more than 50 times in Revelation. 7 is the most used number in Bible itself. And this is the reason they are twisting the power of 7, aka using that good power to destroy mankind. But I have seen this Swastika, guys. If you can, you can put this Swastika, the right one, not the Nazi one, in front of your home, etc. This is a very powerful symbol. It will destroy, you know, all evil things, and it will bring prosperity, everything that you ever desired. It's very good, actually. So we are in this. I have seen this power. Our good times, humanity's good times, has finally started, is what I feel. We are in it for, guys. You can never even imagine what we have seen. God is not what God really is. All the emotions will vanish. This is the power of God, the 7 numbers that I am seeing in incredible places. People will, like, you know, humanity will start to see the manifestation of Swastika. Swastika itself, like, you know, means it's good thing, good vision, Sudarshan Chakra. So all evil will be destroyed. Yeah, guys, just I wanted to like delve deeper into the power of Swastika and Sudarshan Chakra. So the power of Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, Sudarshan Chakra is coming. But you can just keep that Hinduism, because they destroyed a lot when the British came. But you can just go with pure knowledge. And this is what I feel it is. Yeah, guys, thanks.